Hello, hello, hello. Solutions to problem 129. This was the problem. I have cut off some of the text above because we don't need that now. What is important, that each question, it is stated that we have waited a long time. In other words, this is a circuit, and whatever the questions are going to be asked are relevant to after we have waited a long time. After we have waited a long time, both capacitors will be fully charged and there will be no more any current. Therefore, these self-inductors plays no longer any role. In other words, you can simply draw a line here and forget the self-inductance. The answer cannot possibly be influenced by the self-inductor. When you, if there were a switch in here and you would close the switch, surely for some time, your current will be dictated, among other things, among the RC and among the L, will be influenced by RC and by L. But no longer after you wait a long time. In other words, this is not there. Now, that's a very important thing. You must recognize that. Why did I put that in? Well, I wanted to check you, whether you have that insight. Physics is not about equations. Physics is about conceptions. And if you start screwing around with all kinds of LRC circuits, that means you have no feeling for physics. You are blind. You only think in terms of equations, but that's not what physics is about. Next thing. In whatever follows, this is always connected. In other words, no matter what follows, both capacitors must always have the exact same voltage, because the closed loop integral of this circuit must always be zero. That is independent of whether there is a dielectric in here or whether there are 1,000 dielectrics in here. It is independent of whether the voltage is connected and I put in the dielectric, or whether the voltage is not connected, this voltage, and I put in a dielectric. It's independent of that. They must always be the same. They may not always be V, but they will always be the same. So question A, what is the electric field, direction and magnitude between the plates of each capacitor? Potential difference in each case is V. Electric field is in this direction. E is V divided by D. Next question. What now is the electric field between the plates of each capacitor after we put a dielectric, kappa equals 2, on the left? Makes no difference. Potential difference must be the same between here and here. Therefore, it must be V. Whether there is here a dielectric in here or not, or here, it must still be V. It must always be the same. And therefore, question B is, again, electric field is V divided by D in this direction. Most of you have this right. I would say 70% of the answers have this right, maybe 60, because many of you make the mistake in B that you enter somewhere kappa equals 2. That's wrong. Now we go to the third question. And very few of you have that right. Of the roughly maybe 40 answers that I have received, I believe there are only 4 or 5 that have it correct. When we disconnect the battery before inserting the dielectric, each capacitor carries a charge Q equals CV. Given a total charge of 2 CV on the parallel combination, after inserting the dielectric, charge will flow between the left and the right capacitors so as to equalize the voltages. It may not be V, it may be V prime, but they have to be the same on both capacitors. That is non-negotiable. The total charge on the two will remain constant because of charge conservation. The capacitance on the right-hand capacitor is unchanged, so its new charge is Q right equals C V prime. C has not changed. However, the one on the left, the capacitance has changed. It is now kappa times C. Therefore, Q on the left is kappa times Z, CV prime. They have the same V prime. Now, there must be charge conservation. This is a charge on left plus right. That therefore must be this charge plus this charge is 1 plus kappa times CV prime. 3 CV prime. And that must be 2 CV, because charge was conserved. In other words, V prime is 2V divided by 3. So the V prime, which is the same on both capacitors, is now lower than V. It is 2/3 of V. Therefore, the electric field between each capacitor is 2V divided by 3D. Both must have the same electric field because the potential difference over both of them is the same. It is V prime. Very few of you have this. All right. Maybe it is not quite a high school problem. Yes, I think it is. I could do this problem in high school. Let's say it is perhaps an advanced high school problem, and I was maybe in an advanced high school. Okay. Well, if you cannot do this problem, you should really feel bad. Yes, it is so exceptionally simple. Any knowledge that you have about capacitors, C equals Q divided by V, follows from there. And the idea that both are parallel, that they must always have the same potential, regardless of whether one or two or none have any kappa inside, any dielectric inside. All right. Sorry for getting a little bit enthusiastic. We'll be friends, no matter what.